Candace.
Hi, Candace.
Hi, Tonya. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks. How are you?
Doing well, thanks. Thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Of course. You know, as a renowned motivational speaker and body language expert, what are some of your favorite confidence-boosting secrets?
One of the best secrets I think that people don't realize is things really are mind over matter. If I take the time each and every day to do the little things that are going to make me feel better about myself, over the long haul, I'm actually going to feel better about myself. And it's important to do these things each and every day because we like to follow patterns and habits. So I say to people, you know what? First thing in the morning, you get up, you shower, you do your regular thing. Right after that, you put lotion on, maybe you use Jergens Moisture. You want to make sure that you feel that, because what's going to happen is you'll notice the visible smoothness of your skin. After you do that, you get dressed, you wear something that makes a strong statement about who you are that day, and then you head out and you conquer the world. And what do I mean by that? You hold eye contact with people, you smile with people, you engage with people, even if it has to take you out of your comfort zone. These are the things that are going to make you appear charismatic, confident, and dominant.
And how important is skincare?
Skincare is super important for several reasons. Most importantly, because it reflects how we feel about ourselves. So if I don't have the right nourishment on my skin and then I go to shake hands, I'm going to be aware of that. It's going to make me less likely to want to shake hands with someone, as opposed to saying, wow, my skin feels good, I feel good, therefore I can shake hands with confidence.
And is there anything else that we should be doing?
Well, it really depends upon the interaction that you're having, but once you become self-aware of what you're doing, once you know the signals that you're sending out, then you want to be able to read the signals that people are feeding back to you. So I know that I've come across as strong, as dominant, as confident. I've held eye contact. I've made somebody feel special by nodding, smiling, giving them all the cues that they need in order to boost their self-confidence. And now at this point, I want to hear what they say to me non-verbally. And what does that mean? Well, are they open to me? Do they have open body language? Are they smiling back at me? Are they nodding their head as well? Are they keeping their body oriented towards me? Because that's one of the biggest cues. If I'm talking to someone and I don't really want to be talking to them, you'll notice that I might start to shift my body a little bit away. And that's a strong indicator that I'm done with the conversation. And the funny thing is, most people aren't aware of what's going on in their surroundings. So if you're given in that situation and you find that somebody is either coming too close to you or it's starting to turn away from you, that's an indication that there's some discomfort there.
And do you have any additional tips or information you'd like to share with us?
Well, I think one of the most important things that people need to do first and foremost is become self-aware. Make sure that they're monitoring themselves every few minutes, making sure that they know exactly what their body is sending out. And then once they have that down, going out and building rapport with everyone they can.
And where can we go for more information?
If you want information on skincare, go to Jergens.com. If you want information on body language, TonyaReiman.com.
Well, thank you so much, Tonya. We appreciate the great advice. Have a great
afternoon.
Thank
you. You too. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.